Hello, and welcome to another episode of Think About It. I'm Jeff Sutton, Assistant Athletic Director for Media Relations and Broadcasting here at HCU, and I'm joined today by junior right-handed pitcher Walker Zander. Walker, thank you for joining us.
Of course, thank you for having me.
All right, so to get started, let's just talk a little bit about, you know, where you come from, you know, where you grew up, and then how did you end up at HCU?
Well, it's been a long journey. So I grew up not too far down the road, Spring Branch, Moyle area. Went to Memorial High School. Played baseball my whole life growing up. You know, fell in love with it. Wanted to keep playing, and that led me to playing junior college at Blinn, then in Brenham, and that was great for a year. And then ended up transferring to Weatherford Junior College for my sophomore year, and that was when COVID hit. So that was a roller coaster that kind of affected everyone in their own special way. And for me, that was just trying to find a new place to play, a new home. You know, didn't want to stay in junior college for too long. You know, wanted to, you know, focus on getting a degree, and got blessed with the opportunity to go play at Texas A&M for 2 years. Ended up getting my degree, University Studies Business, got my Aggie ring, and then, you know, had a long season last year. Ended up going to the College World Series, which was great. Had a great time playing with those guys and those coaches. But graduated, you know, felt like there was somewhere better for me personally, and made a decision to, you know, try to find a new place to play. And kind of right away, HBU, we're now HCU, stuck out to me. And you know, here I am, and you know, couldn't be happier to be here.
So you're, you know, obviously had a great experience. You got to go to the College World Series, really cool thing. I'm sure there's a lot that you can take from that. But when you were looking for that new place for you, and that ended up being HCU, what stood out about the school? What was it, you know, the coaching staff, the school, what convinced you that this was that place?
Yeah, so there were, you know, coming from A&M, there were a couple other schools that that kind of reached out to me, and even a couple others that I reached out to as well. But it was kind of obvious to me right away that HCU was the right option. You know, having, you know, Lance Berkman here, Coach Berkman, that's, you know, amazing. Playing for him was kind of the initial, like, wow, this would be a good place to play. And then I got to meet the other coaches, and they were just, they seemed like they really, really wanted me to be here. They're very proactive about getting me here, and it seemed like they really, really wanted me to be on this team. And that, you know, kind of hit home for me. I was like, yeah, this is a place I want to be, you know, where I feel like I'm really, really wanted. And, you know, that felt great. And then being close to home, you know, obviously it's pretty nice, you know, big family person. So I'm able to go home and do that. But yeah, I mean, I just felt like the coaching staff really, really, you know, showed that they wanted me. And I've heard great things about the school, and, you know, I haven't regretted my decision one bit. So,
okay, that's great. So talk, you know, you mentioned, you know, Coach Berkman was obviously a big draw. Talk a little bit about him as a coach and kind of what he brings to the team, to practices, to the program.
Yeah. So, I mean, for anyone, even with the experience that Coach Berkman has, I mean, you know, going to coach a Division I school is not an easy task. And this being his second year, you know, I think he's doing a great job. He's able to kind of take his experience from you know, from the majors, and the positive or negative, he's able to kind of relate to the things that we do in practice in the game, and really give us valuable lessons that's going to help moving forward. And, you know, he's someone you can trust too. You know, he's not only just a coach talking to you about baseball this, baseball that, but, you know, he talks to you about life. You know, he helped us grow in our faith. I mean, you saw he, you know, helped baptize some of the guys on the team, just stuff like that. Just a great man and great coach, you know. So it's not only is he just a coach, but, you know, someone that, you know, look forward to just hanging around with.
So, you know, you mentioned your kind of your road to HCU and involved, you know, this is the fourth school now that you've been at. So, you know, you've obviously experienced some very different types of places, different types of schools. What has stood out about HCU in that regard? You know, taking baseball out of it, but, you know. Yeah. As far as the school, getting your degree, you've earned your undergrad degree. Mm-hmm. So, kind of, what have you seen about the school that has stood out for?
You know, it's a smaller school, and I like that. Kind of get to know everybody. you know, a lot better. And I also feel like I've been able to grow my faith a lot, which is, you know, most important. And just the guys on the team, and, you know, people I've met on campus, like, in, it's just great. It's smaller, and I've got to know a lot of people, you know, more personally than I have in the past, and that is great. And I'm doing a master's in management and entrepreneurship online, so I haven't had the, you know, a lot of experience on campus, but, you know, the times I've been on campus, I mean, it's a great campus. I love everyone. I love being around, you know, everyone. And, you know, so far my experience here has been great.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Just still talking a little bit about, you know, the time that you've been in college, and mm-hmm. we were talking a little bit earlier about how, you know, it's been a solid impact, and you said things happen for a reason. Mm-hmm. You know, talk about that a little bit. I mean, it can be a good and a bad thing kind of moving around to different places, but
yeah.
You know, what are some of those positives that have come from it in your life?
From going to being at four different
yeah,
schools?
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. I mean, it's definitely showed me a lot of value lessons in life. Kind of, you know, I've been through a lot of tough times, really. And baseball has kind of taught me, you know, just to keep going and to always kind of reflect on, you know, the things that you maybe didn't do right, and always find ways to improve, you know, always find ways to get better. And, you know, not to dwell on things that didn't go your way. I mean, the things didn't really go my way at Blinn, but I could have just said, nah, I don't want to play baseball anymore, and just, you know, join a fraternity or whatever. I mean, nothing wrong with that, but I could have just gave up on the baseball dream. But I was like, no, like, I'm going to learn from it, I'm going to get better. And, you know, I've had an incredible journey. It's been tough, but I mean, I wouldn't change it. Just the people that I've met throughout this process has been great. I mean, I've had lifelong friends from every school that I've been to, and, you know, it's great. You know, there's not a lot of things I haven't seen from that standpoint. So, you know, that whole, I think definitely the positives far outweigh the negatives of, you know, kind of moving around from university to university. I have another year of eligibility, and I don't think it's going to happen again. So I don't think I'll be at a fifth university.
Okay. Yeah. So, you know, you mentioned you're working on your master's in management entrepreneurship.
Mm-hmm.
What, you know, where do you want that to lead for you? Why that for a master's?
Yeah, that's a good question. Because I really personally don't exactly know the answer to it. You know, I've put so much time and effort into baseball. You know, I really do not know what I want to do after baseball.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'd like to start my own business. Something like that, but it's still something that I'm really, really trying to put the pieces together. I've been working on my resume, so that is something that's kind of in the works for me. But, you know, nothing wrong with that, with all that experience that I get from these degrees. So I'm learning, kind of trying to figure out exactly what I want to do.
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so kind of shifting back to baseball a little bit. You know, season a little over a month in now.
Yeah.
You know, what are the team's goals, you know, for this season? What are you guys, what's going to make this a season that you guys look back at and say, we did what we were trying to do?
Well, you know, obviously we haven't had the start that we've wanted to, but with that, I mean, we've had a pretty tough schedule, and we're learning a lot about the team now. We're learning the things that we're going to need to know, you know, come conference. And, you know, with the start we've had, I mean, I think it'll be amazing to just turn around and shock everyone with what we're going to do in later in the season. I mean, our goal is to, you know, win the conference tournament and compete in the playoffs. I mean, that should be the goal of everyone on this team, is to compete in the playoffs and just to, you know, stick together as a team and keep loving one another and just keep trying to find ways to get better. And the coaches are going to, you know, on the same page, you know, so.
Okay. So you personally, you know, pitcher, what's your arsenal of pitches? What do you throw?
So I got a four seam, a two seam fastball, and a slider, and a changeup.
Okay. And what's your favorite pitch to throw? If you came up against a hitter and you had, you know, one pitch that you were going to go to get him out, what do you throw?
Yeah. Well, recently I've really loving the four seam. Four seam up and away, it's up and away to a righty, up and in to a lefty. I mean, it's been really productive for me. And then the slider too, put away a guy, low and away slider. I mean, that's been two really good pitches for me. But right now, I mean, the fastball has been been really working for me, been able to put it exactly where I want it to go. So.
Okay. So let's talk about, you know, just finish up here. What's your favorite thing about the team that you're on here at HCU?
I mean, kind of heard me say this a couple of times. I mean, it's got to be just the people, you know. Just, I mean, that's kind of all it's about, is just kind of getting to know everyone and you know, getting to compete with your friends. I mean, it's great. I mean, we have just a bunch of different guys that just all get along together. I mean, coming from A&M last year, I mean, I think the reason that team had a successful year was because of that team camaraderie. Like, everyone, you know, wanted to play for each other. And although it doesn't look like we're having the season we want to right now, I mean, everything happens for a reason. But, I mean, it's so easy to play, to go and play for these guys. I mean, I look forward to going to the field every day and getting to see the guys, getting to see the coaches, and just, you know, having a good time and to compete, play baseball.
Yeah, and that's great. And like I said, it's important because the reality is, you know, you're bringing in people that don't know each other and putting them all together.
All different backgrounds.
And, you know, and it's every year, and you're always hoping that it works out well that way. Mm-hmm. So that's great.
Yeah.
So yeah, I know you guys have conference coming up here soon. Mm-hmm. First weekend is against McNeese here at home. So you got four conference series at home coming up.
Yeah.
So Husky fans, be sure to get out to Husky Field, support the Huskies as they take on their Southland Conference opponents over the next couple months. For more information on the baseball team and all Husky athletics, visit hcuhuskies.com, HCU Athletics on Twitter, at HCU Huskies on Instagram. And thank you very much for joining us today.